Welcome to another tutorial. This is Neil from Sliced Pictures. We're going to be looking at basically how to set up your project's work in DaVinci Resolve. I know I kind of been through this a little bit in the previous tutorial, which was a bit longer. Well, it's quite long. But this one's going to look at this project manager and project settings, and also we're going to look at how we can work with EDL XML from Premiere. This is Premiere CC, Premiere version. So what's really important and very useful in initial startups with DaVinci is the settings, getting the settings right so you know you've got no problems in the future. So obviously we can see the time base here is 29.97 and 1920 by 1080. We can see the frame, there's the sizes and all that, that's all good. So we know our frame rate, we know the source file is also, clicking on that, we can see that this frame rate is 29.97. And scroll down a little bit, we can see it's 1920 by 1080. So we know the sequence is matching everything that our source file is also got. Yeah, so everything is matching, this is our perfect sequence, perfect source files. So we can go into the file and export. We can do a Final Cut Pro XML. Let's call this Jazz 2, just because, let's write that properly, Jazz 2. There we go, and save. Doesn't take very long to do XMLs. Okay, and this generally will come up, usually because of some issues might have occurred, but unless you've got filters and stuff attached to these clips, then you shouldn't have any problem when you're working with XMLs between Premiere and Final Cut and stuff like that. So let's jump back into our project manager. So our project manager has default settings always when we open. So if I open a new one called Jazz 2, let's create our project. There's our Jazz 2, 1920 by 24. See, we can see that 24 frames has come up. This is the default setting. So if I open that, we know that they're not matching. So our frame rates aren't matching from our what we're gonna use in our source file and what we've got in our current project. What we can do with that is have a look at our project settings. So our project settings, and the most important one in our project settings is our conform options. This is what is gonna work between our XML, our source file, and DaVinci. So just make sure that this one is matching and stick on the use drop frame timecode. Embed the source in the source clip, the time code, that's fine. You can also, from the source clip, frame count, whatever you want to choose. They're both fine. Now, I changed these purely just so then I know all the settings are matching and everything. So we're good with that. Our frame rate, we can just quickly change. We're happy with all of this. We're happy with 422 because we know that it's ProRes. We'll go into here and change this to 1080p 29.97, and our conform is all good. We'll hit apply. We can also look at our capture and playback. Now I changed this just because I like to have conformity across like everything, so I know it's all the same. 422 with our UYB. So that's fine because we're using Pro Resolution 422 as our codec. Put that back, and so we hit apply again. So now we should be all good when we go to look at our source files. So let's go quickly and have a look at our source file. Here's our guy. So again, like, make sure you import all of those source files that you've already edited. Anything that you haven't edited and you're not going to use, don't worry about it. So now here's our clip, 1920 1080 ProRes 422, so the YUV 422 is matching. Frame rate is 29.97. If I look at my sequence settings and my conform settings on my setting here, 29.97 should be. Now when I import this into my media pool, nothing happens. Yeah, that's basically, nothing's happened because we've matched all the settings across the board, which is very cool. If the settings don't match, then what you would have to do is it would come up with a kind of small little box about here, somewhere here, and it would basically say, projects do not, you know, your project setting does not match your clip setting. So do you want to change it? It's up to you if you want to change it through that, or you want to, you know, change it manually like I do before you actually start importing your media. I would suggest, you know, set it up and then you don't have to worry about it. You know it's set up and it's good to go. All right, so that is basically the media that I've got in Premiere. These are the clips that I've got in my timeline. So obviously this is what I'm working with. So when I'm in here, I've got these six clips. When I'm in here, I've got like six clips. So I can go into my edit, and this is where I would just go in and I would import my XML. My XML would be in here. There's my XML, Jazz 2 XML. We open that, and this is also gonna then tell us our information. Sequence one was the name of the timeline, and that's what we're importing. 1920, 1080, and there's our frame rate, 29.97. And we're using this, obviously this is coming from Final Cut, but we exported the XML from Premiere, so it doesn't make any real difference. So we hit okay. Obviously, I've got 4 of 22 clips were not yet found. Now, if I look here, there's a load of stuff I've got in my project folders. I've got a load of clips here, so I'm not worried, so I don't really care. And also the text, you see these text here, it's probably not recognizing these 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of text because I haven't imported those pieces of text, which is fine. I don't want the text, I don't need the text, so no, I don't want to search for it. There it is. Oh, there we go. Look, see, the text has failed to import, which is fine. Don't care because it's text. And there we go. So I've imported my XML. This now matches with all of my source files, my time code matching, and I'm all set up. I'm ready to go in terms of coloring and grading. I know it's a bit boring to do this, but if you get it right, you know, it just becomes a habit to get it right. So then now you would just, you know, you can start cracking on and color correcting what you want to color correct and work with your clips. Obviously, if you've got any power grades or stills or memories already loaded into your DaVinci setup from your in your gallery here, if your gallery works, then it should come up and show you your power grade options here. Obviously, you know, I can pull it in and then save a lot of time because I've already graded this, or because this is a different shot, I can work with a new grade. I can start one all on my own. All right, that was just a really quick one. Check out the other tutorials. They're on Vimeo. There's a couple on there so far. I will be doing some more looking at particular styles. So probably not using this footage. I might, but I doubt it. I'll probably use some other footage. And also I will look at some raw files as well soon. So I'll be getting some red one or maybe some Blackmagic, because this works obviously very well with Blackmagic camera. Some raw files so we can actually look at, you know, the raw information and how we can work with that, which really is fantastic. DaVinci is really great for that. So I will see you guys soon. Hope you enjoyed this one. Check out everything else. Catch you guys later on.